Hi there and welcome back to Delali. In today's video, we will look at the importance of sleep mode in our electronics and Arduino projects. We will also look at what modifications we can make to our hardware to make it more efficient and consume less power. Come along. Let's take things from the top. Over here, we have two 3.3 volt 8 MHz Arduino Pro Minis. I have not made any modifications to the hardware, so this is exactly as it comes right from the manufacturer. I have uploaded some code on there that turns on the onboard LED for 2 seconds, turns it off, waits 8 seconds, and then repeats the cycle. However, this board only waits for that 8 seconds, while this other board sleeps during that 8 second duration. Let's now take a look at the difference in power consumption or current draw. So this is how everything is wired in order for us to read the current consumption. So the 5 volts from the power supply goes to the positive of the multimeter, and then the negative of the multimeter goes to the raw pin of the Arduino Pro Mini, and then from the ground back to the power supply's negative. This is the code I use for setup A and this for setup B. The only difference between the two is I used a low power library here and added one extra line of code for putting the board to sleep for 8 seconds, while this other one just waited 8 seconds. Over here on the multimeter, we can see the board consumes 5.4 milliamps while waiting and about 6.8 when the LED is on. So we go ahead and write that down. 6.8 milliamps and 5.4. milliamps. Let's now move the multimeter to this board. Once again, we can see about 1.4 milliamps when the board is sleeping and 6.8 when the LED is on. So we'll go ahead and record that as well. After measuring the current draw between setup A and setup B, we see that setup A saves 4 milliamps of current just by sleeping as compared to setup B that just waits during that period. To see how significant 4 milliamps of current is, we would have to use a duration calculator. Let's first imagine we use this 2200 milliamp hour 18650 battery for our test. Let's start with setup B. Given a battery capacity of 2200 milliamp hour, it had 8 seconds of sleep, or 8 seconds it should have been sleeping, and consumed a current of about 5.4 milliamps. So we'll change this here to milliamps. And then the time spent awake is 2 seconds, which it uses to turn on the LED. And then from there, it draws about 6.8 milliamps during that period. So if we click calculate here, we can see approximately this battery, which is a 2200 milliamp hour 18650 battery, would be able to keep this board working for 387 hours. Now let's take a look at setup A. Given that setup A also draws the same amount of current while awake, all we need to change here is the sleep current. So we will change this to 1.4. And then upon clicking calculate again, we can see setup A is going to last for 887 hours. So this is more than 2 times the duration of setup B. And this was achieved by sleeping during that 8 second period and saving 4 milliamp in the process. Further dividing the hour values by 24, we have 36 days or approximately 37 days for setup A, and for setup B, we have 16 days. So you can just see the huge difference between the two. At this point, we can stop this video here as we've seen the importance of sleep mode demonstrated. However, sleep mode is not just about adding extra lines of code to put the board to sleep when it's idle. The overall efficiency of sleep mode is directly tied to the external components or parts that make it into the final build of any project. If we take a closer look, we will notice that this green LED remained on throughout the operation of the board. That means that this green LED contributed to the figures we recorded earlier. In actual fact, we programmed this LED to blink in between sleep and wake cycles to let us know the board was receiving power, and this can be replicated for any other project. We do not need this green LED to be on the whole time. That said, let's go ahead and desolder this green LED on setup A to see what the new current draw figures are.
you have successfully desoldered the onboard LED. Let's run the test again.
Turning on the power supply, we can see the system draws up to 5.45 milliamps when in operation and about 0.02 when asleep. So we can see the significant jump between the 1.4 milliamp it was initially drawing to 0.02 just by removing the onboard LED. And now putting these new figures into the calculator software, we can see changing from 0.02 during sleep and 5.45 when awake leads to 1,989 hours, which is significantly higher than the previous value we saw during sleep mode. And so dividing this figure by 24, we now have 82.88 or approximately 83 days. And we can just see the difference between this and that. Kindly note that 0.02 milliamps is the same as 20 microamps. At this point, we have to ask ourselves, is there anything else we can improve on this board? And the answer, as always, is yes. We can improve the regulator. We can swap out the original MIC5205 low dropout 3.3 volt regulator that comes with the Pro Mini for a 3.3 volt MCP1702. Looking at the data sheet of the MIC5205 that comes with the Pro Mini, we can see that it's a 150 milliamp regulator. If we take a look at the MCP1702, we can see that it's a 250 milliamp low quiescent current regulator. And by quiescent current, we mean the amount of current it consumes when it's idle. And that value is 2 microamps, which is significantly low. So this is a much better regulator for our Pro Mini. So let's go ahead and set up this regulator and measure the current values again. At this point in the video, a thumbs up will greatly improve my sleep quality. For that, here is a picture of my cat. This is the schematic for the new setup. So we have here our power supply. The 5 volts from the power supply goes into the regulator, and then out from the regulator goes 3.3 volts to the multimeter, and then from the multimeter to the Pro Mini, and then back to the power supply and the regulator. So that is that. So now turning this on, we can see the board draws a total of about 5.3, and when it's in sleep, it draws 0.007. This is equivalent to 7 microamps. Let's now put these new values into the duration calculator. Once again, over here, we'll change this to 0.07. And then this went lower, so we'll change it also to 5.3. And after calculation, we can see this figure moves forward even more. Further dividing this value by 24, we have 86 days, which is 3 more days than we saw previously. At this point, I believe we've seen the importance of why we should implement sleep mode in our Arduino project and the need to pick our parts and components much carefully. We saw that utilizing sleep mode alone in setup A saved us 4 milliamps, and that equaled an operation time of approximately 37 days, as opposed to setup B that would only last 16 days because it was just idle. Also, by removing the onboard LED, we're able to further reduce the sleep current consumption to 20 microamps, which increased our operation time to 83 days. And by swapping out the original regulator, we're able to extend that 83-day duration to 86. You've been watching Delali, and it's been nice having you. If you are new here, kindly subscribe to stay in touch on how to design and build more cool stuff. Make sure to check out the channel and check out our other videos. See you next time.